Welcome back inside the Bell Center. Here in Montreal, a city where the LA Kings in franchise history have never won back-to-back games. Still trying to do that tonight. As your starting goaltenders for this game, we'll see Martin Jones in net for the LA Kings. He had the shutout for LA last time in this building. He's the third fastest goaltender to reach six career shutouts, tying Tony Esposito, who did it in 26 games back in 1969 with the Blackhawks. Well, Carey Price is 3-1 in his career against the Los Angeles Kings. Daryl Sutter, the fastest coach in LA Kings history to win 100 games. Back behind the bench tonight to lead his troops as this one is underway with Greg Kinnear and Steve Kozari as your officials tonight. Pierre Rastico and Derek Manson will work the lines. Alex Galchenyuk along the boards, checked by Dustin Brown. Slides it back for Alexei Yemelin. He'll try to work it along, but Kopitar broke it up and sends it up for Jake Muzzin. Pacioretty cut him off. Gallagher for Galchenyuk. Tried to drop it back. It goes off his skate as Dustin Brown is on it. And he'll get a fire into the Canadian zone, but it's off the stick of Yemelin. Price out of the goal and move it for Pacioretty. Off for Alexei Yemelin. Yemelin's going to wait. Wants to survey the ice here. Jared Stoll intent to watch from the top of the circle, and instead of a pass that works out, it ends up being an icing against Montreal.
Well, tonight we're going to be treated to two of the game's best as far as defensemen go. Drew Doughty in time, and obviously P.K. Subban here in Montreal, both members of that Olympic gold medal team in Sochi. Doughty second in the league in ice time, and P.K. Subban obviously a former Norris Trophy winner. Something that Drew Doughty has yet to accomplish, which is pretty amazing when you think about it, because you think a two-time Olympic champion, a couple Stanley Cups, but still has not won that Norris.
Andrew Ghetto lifts it off the boards. Green will bat it down in the air. Gonchar's there, and he'll send it back into the Kings zone. Green going after it. Poked it up the wing. Knocked down. Plaketic couldn't handle the bouncing puck. Comes to Subban. Subban finding a little room. Trying to center. Andrew Ghetto lifts it to the air and couldn't get it to the net. Williams had his clearing attempt picked off. Plaketic towards the goal. Andrew Ghetto got his stick on that, then gets upended by Brendan McNabb. Here's Plaketic with it. Spinning around with a shot. Jones kicks it out. Markov throwing it towards the net. Andrew Ghetto trying to deflect it. Plaketic back across for Andrew Ghetto. Couldn't reach down with his McNabb. Will hand it off for Williams. Williams stripped of the puck by Sakach. And finally, the Kings get it to center as Stoll will throw it in. Sakach will play it back for Andre Markov. Markov is going to wait there. Now feeds it up. Ahead for Brandon Prust. But Drew Doughty got a piece of it as Pearson will bring it in. Drops for Lewis with a snapshot. Off the stick handle of Price, and it'll sail over the glass into the net.
Well, I mentioned tonight we're going to have the pleasure of watching two very creative defensemen. This is the thing with P.K. Subban. He's not afraid to try things. Look at the nice little curl and drag there. He's the last man back, but he's got the confidence to try and make a play. And there's Drew Doughty. Just a nice little simple pass up the middle of the ice. Both players can do the fancy things, but they can also do the simple things when need be.
Barry Price said go to the bench to get a new stick there. That shot probably splintered his stick handle the way it hit it. As Carter on the draw threw it in front, cleared away by Prust. Desharnais is on it, and he shoots it in the LA bench. Daryl Sutter had a dive for cover there. Well, Carey Price has been the recipient of the Molson Cup several times for the Montreal Canadiens, and once again did it for the month of November as he was honored prior to the face-off here tonight, and he's been outstanding for the Canadiens all season long. Price on the puck now. Lays it back around, intended for Gilbert, couldn't get there. Kotter turned it over. Here's a chance. Lewis in the slot, and Price is there to steer it aside. Muzzin will tap it in. Pearson after the puck. Tanner Pearson in the corner. Throws it out. Lewis again with a shot. Price is saved. He'll squeeze the pads and doesn't allow that one to squeak through.
Nice job by Carey Price making sure the five hole was closed on that shot there. And Carey Price, You look at him handle the puck there. Does a nice little reverse play, but then it's lost on the sideboards. The puck comes to the high slot. Price does a nice job of coming out and cutting down the angle. But he's been extremely hot at home. He's very comfortable here at the Bell Center. You look at the record, 6-1, 1.57 goals against average, and the outstanding 0.939 save percentage. He's got some exceptional numbers here at the Bell Center.
Martinez with it, hands it off. Kyle Clifford with a shot, hit the leg of Manny Malhotra, and it'll jet back down the ice to the Kings zone. Alec Martinez is up. Lays it across as the Kings try to break out once again. Tyler Toffoli got it through center, intercepted by Yemelin. He'll flip it back to the LA line. Robin Regier got it ahead for Mike Richards. Clifford going after him, takes a hit from Conchar. Martinez trying to commit for the point, got to it. One of our can't clear it. Yemelin trying to take it away, and it's Manny Malhotra that'll swoop in to grab the puck. Feeds it across to Gonchar. Up the middle, Barbeau will carry it in, dropping for Malhotra with a shot off a stick, and nearly fooled Jones.
Malhotra almost got his first of the season right there.
Kings now resetting in their own zone. Alec Martinez is on it. Hands it across for Jake Muzzin. Back over to Dustin Brown. Brown entering the zone. Dropping it off for Kopitar. Trying to elude the check of Markov. Kopitar will slide it around. Onto the stick of Gamarik. He's hit on the play. Brown in to help out. Battle in Galchenyuk. Subban knocks his man down. Brown is on it with a shot. Place the save. He bats it up in the air. And Markov will punch it ahead. Chopped back in by Muzzin. Now Brown hit by Subban, and that'll be a penalty. P.K. Subban is going to head to the box for boarding, and the L.A. Kings will go to the power play.
Yeah, P.K. Subban getting his arms up and saying, can't really believe he's getting
Until
called on this one.
76, 2 minutes boarding.
He's going to get a boarding call. You take a look, it's on Dustin Brown here, and Subban closes the gap fairly quickly, and it's one of those things where Brown doesn't get himself quite close to enough to the boards, and it's a difficult call. And then you look at earlier, Manny Malhotra almost gets his first goal of the season. Nice little drop pass by Michael Barnabell. And I don't think Jones saw that. Malhotra's been a little bit snake-bitten a bit of late. Almost got his first.
Doughty with a shot that's wide. Muzzin is back on it. Kings 16.7% on the power play. Good for 20th in the league. Kopitar for Doughty. Handing it across. Muzzin with a shot. That one missed the target. Kopitar on it again. Plays it into the skates of Carter. He's got trouble with it, but he'll get it for Doughty. Quickly across for Muzzin. Back to Drew Doughty. Muzzin on it again. Feeds it down low, and it's flipped up over the net by Gemmer. Kopitar to Doughty. Tip pass. Throw it in front, and again, Gabarik on top of the blue paint with a deflection that ends up out of play.
Nice puck movement by the Los Angeles Kings. Kings are starting to play some better hockey as late. They got off to a slow start. Still just ninth in the West in the Western Conference. And you think about the Los Angeles Kings, last year's Stanley Cup winner. You don't picture them being on the outside looking in, but they're really starting to get their game together right now. And they played extremely well in Ottawa last night, winning 4-2.
Jared Stoll scrummed off the draw. Kings get the puck. Martinez trying to get it. That shot is deflected to the corner as Markov is checked by Stoll. Jared Stoll trying to move it. Threw it back into the feet of Markov. Up the boards. Pacioretty got it off the skate of Martinez. A fortuitous bounce as it comes to Plekanec. Right back for Pacioretty with a shot, and that got blocked. Brown resets, handing it out for Williams, but he lost it at the line. And Braden McNabb is back on it. Feeding it over to Jared Stoll, and the Kings reset with 49 seconds to go in their power play. Braden McNabb across to Jared Stoll. Finds a little room on the wing. Stoll will throw it around. Martinez there waiting for it. Alec Martinez walks the line, looks to the net, hands it off. Brown with a chance trying to get it for Williams, and that went through the slot. McNabb back on it. Braden McNabb shoots. That one is wide of the net. He's hoping to use the screen in front. Jared Stoll for Williams, hanging on to the puck. Williams trying to slide it by Markov. Markov put it up the glass. Williams knocked it down, takes the shot, and it's off the outside of the net. 12 seconds to go in the power play. McNabb fires. Didn't get through. Second effort does, and it's kicked up by Price. Stoll back for McNabb again. McNabb off for Williams. Williams in the slot. Stoll can't get to him. Malhotra to the line. Kept in by L.A. Williams feeds it over to Martinez. Subban is out of the box. The power play is over. Here's Brown with a shot. Stopped by Price, stretching out the pad. He holds it out. Williams throws it blindly in front. Bonneval intercepts, and the Canadians get it to their own line, and Malhotra will clear it.
Nice job by the Canadians on the penalty kill and settling things down. Got a little frantic there in the last few seconds.
7-2 of the shots favoring LA. They had three of them on that power play. Here's Gilbert on net. Jones the save. Rebound clear to the line, and Gilbert keeps it in. Sven Andrighetto pokes it back in the net. Plekanec's there waiting for it. Comes around the boards. Tyler Toffoli trying to move it. Toffoli had it knocked away. Nathan Beaulieu works it over to Gilbert. Throws it towards the net. It skips wide. Here's Toffoli feeding it out at center. Gilbert's back after it. He'll pick it up. Gilbert got crossed up with Andrighetto at the line, and that ends up being an offside against Montreal. Carey Price holding the fort. Scoreless here early at the Bell Centre with the Canadiens hockey on Sportsnet. Join Club 1909 and collect points for just being a fan. Exchange them for money can't buy products and experiences. Tonight's unique game code is Bergevin. Log on to your club1909.com account in the next 15 minutes and earn 5 points by entering this code. 7-3, the shots favoring the Kings early in the game, but Carey Price has been shot for Montreal, and it's scoreless.
Price has had to be busy, especially on that last power play. Made some key saves.
Gilbert hands it across for Nathan Beaulieu. He'll ring it into the LA zone. Valentin trying to find it, all tangled up with Jamie McBain. Brandon Prust digs it out, trying to slide it for Desharnais. Desharnais will lift it back for Palantau. He's hit on the play, finds the puck, lifted back on the boards. Desharnais knocked it down and took the check from Kyle Clifford, and LA gets it out. Tyler Toffoli lifts it in on net. Price gloves it and has nowhere to go with it, so he's forced to hold it for the whistle.
Well, Carey Price has had to be busy early on, especially on that last penalty kill for the Canadiens. He made some huge stops. You look at him in the net, he's just so calm. And this is what you want and what you expect from Carey Price early on in the game. Give your team a chance to settle in and get themselves in the game. You're playing the defending Stanley Cup champions. And for some of the younger Montreal Canadiens, that can sometimes be unnerving, especially early on in a hockey game.
Malhotra on the draw of the corner, but Pearson came up with it. He'll slide it to the line. McNabb will lift it back in deep. Cavaliers trying to play. Fell down there in a battle with Alexei Yemelin. Pearson knocked over by Yemelin. Carter up with it. Down low for Lewis. Trying to fight off Gonchar. Lewis continues to be worked over. Knocked down. Pearson got it in front. Taken away by Plekanec. And he'll get it out as Green hustles back after it. Chopped it ahead for Pearson, broken up. Gallagher moves it forward to Pacioretty. Pacioretty will lift it into the corner, and Gallagher's after it. Takes a hit on the play. Galchenyuk will bat it to the point. Markov wasn't there yet, and the Canadiens are forced back. Pacioretty lifts it in for Gallagher. That guy tipped as Brown came off the bench, but the change was good. Canadiens stopped maybe for a second. It would have been too many men. Pacioretty lifts it in. He's upended, and that'll be a penalty. Drew Doughty got the hip in the way of Pacioretty. He'll go to the box, and the Canadiens will get their first chance on the power play.
Los Angeles penalty number 8. 2 minutes. Interference.
That's going to be their best penalty killer. Drew Doughty going to the box here for an interference call. And Pacioretty, look, he does the smart thing. He sees it's a one-on-two, so what does he do? He decides to chip the puck in, and he keeps his feet moving. That's the key. You keep your feet moving and make the defenseman step up and interfere with you.
So the Canadiens' power play goes to work. Just 11 power play goals so far in the season at 13.6%. That's 25th in the league. LA's penalty kill, 8th in the league, 84.3%. They have allowed 16 power play goals against. Here's Subban up with it. Takes the shot, scores! Jiří Sekáč may have got a stick on that shot from Subban. It's the shutout hustler against Martin Jones, and the Canadians get the opening goal.
And this all starts off the faceoff. It's a clean win by Thomas Plekanec, but watch what Subban does. He takes the puck to the middle of the ice and improves his shooting angle here, and he doesn't have to let the big slap shot go. There's traffic in front. The key is Subban gets to the middle, and it's that quick snapshot about 4 inches off the ice. And I do believe Plekanec is going to get this goal because I think he got a stick on it.
And that ends the shutout streak for Martin Jones as well. They're crediting the goal to PK Subban for now, but we'll see if they end up changing that later. It did look like the puck got redirected.
I just love the aggressive play to take that puck to the middle with the speed PK did. It set the whole thing up.
Puck lifted back into the Montreal zone. Yemelin going after it, but they'll flow it down against LA and bring the faceoff back outside.
Have another look at this goal, and it all starts. Plekanec wins the draw clean, and that gives Subban enough time to get to the middle. And he didn't have, although he got to the middle that quick, he didn't have enough time for the slap shot. And I love the decision. It's just a quick snapper, get it on net, and when you get that puck on net, good things will happen, especially when you have traffic.
And Plekanec did indeed get his stick on that shot, so I think they'll change that goal. And Jevgeny Plekanec will end up with his fifth of the season, second power play marker, ending Martin Jones' shutout streak at 154 minutes and 17 seconds.
Plekanec is starting to get some good chemistry with Thomas Plekanec. I like how he went right to the net there.
Here's Galchenyuk, handing it off for Gallagher, trying to win the battle against the veteran Robin Regier. Played it back for Pacioretty, hopped over his stick, and now a break for Williams. Subban is back. Williams holds, shoots, off the arm of Price. Jared Stoll lifting it back for Williams again, trying to cut in the slot. Pacioretty got in his way, and that'll force Williams back to center. Jake Muzzin hands it off for Drew Doughty. Worked ahead, Gabbert finding a little room. Hits it down to the Canadian zone. Yemelin swipes it away. Galchenyuk will help it up the boards as Doughty blocks that one. Barkov lays it across for Alexei Yemelin. Lifting it up the middle, and that puck will skip out. Jake Muzzin brings it right back in, dropping it for Kopitar. Andre Kopitar trying to get it in front. Intercepted by Parenteau, and he'll clear it, but Dustin Brown does a good job to get in Parenteau's way and doesn't allow him to chase the puck down. Drew Doughty. Building speed through center. Hands it off for Clifford. Firing on net. Price to stop. Dustin Brown puts it back on goal, and Price was in position. Kopitar lays it across. Gonchar is there. He'll hand it off for Parenteau. And P.A. Parenteau rolls it into the King zone. Brandon Cross tracking it down. Lifts a stick of McMahon. That allows Parenteau to get the puck. Dan May comes in to help out, but Parenteau's stick comes up, clips McNabb, and he's going to get called. So Parenteau goes to the box, and the Kings go to the power play, but it's Montreal leading on a power play goal. 1-0 the score on Sportsnet.
Kinnick's had another strong game so far, but now the Canadians are going to have to kill off a P.A. Parenteau penalty as just gets the stick up on Brayden McNabb there for a high sticking call.
So the Kings on their second power play of the night as Drew Doughty will start out with it. Doughty handing it off for Gabbert, who dumps it in. Got away from Price back of the net. Carter had to settle it down on the boards. Doughty ends up with it. Drew Doughty feeds it for Kopitar. Back for Carter. Off to Kopitar again. Poked away by Markov, and the puck will come out at center. Carter will float it over to Jake Muzzin. Now back for Kopitar. Lifted into the Canadian zone. Price blocks it, sees the lane himself, cleared it, and then Jake Muzzin got his hand out to block the puck, and it ended up deflecting off his hand and into his face. Doughty feeds it over onto the wing for Gabbert. Doughty worked over by PK Subban. Gabbert got it up the boards. Muzzin holds it in at the line. Jake Muzzin feeds it across for Kopitar. Had to settle it down. Kopitar taking his time with it. Lays it off for Gabbert. Going back to Kopitar. Plekanec's watching him. Had the stick in the right lane, broken up and got it out. But Pacioretty couldn't get by Drew Doughty. Good defensive play by Doughty. Carter dropping it for Gambrick, holds the line, feeds it over to Muzzin with a shot, hoists a save as Carter's right back on it. Subban will meet him in the corner. Throw it out front, Muzzin, all along, waiting out. Threw it back to front, it goes off a skate into flex wide. Muzzin had a little bit too much time on his hands, wasn't sure exactly what to do. Martinez hands it across as Pearson deflects it in. Yemelin trying to move it in the corner. Richards is there, swung it around and at the line. Martinez will keep it in. Feeds it across for Pearson off the stick. The power play is over as Palatow is out of the box and he'll knock it across for Dale Weiss. Martinez at center, played it right back in. Yemelin got it up the boards. That one will come out and it's Martinez that'll fire it right back in as the Kings clear the zone. Yemelin hands it across for Gilbert. Played up to Dale Weiss in his skates. He's checked and the Canadians get it right back as Yemelin will fire it in. Jared Stoll sends it back for Martinez. Played across for Toffoli. And Robin Regier up to Dustin Brown. Brown is in, trying to flip it across for Stoll. That puck got away from him. Galchenyuk's there, took a hit on the boards. Williams knocks it down. Williams trying to get it in front, comes across to Muzzin, fakes the shot, throws it towards the net, tipped away by Price, and it's batted away from the front of the goal. Muzzin across for Dustin Brown, tried to throw it towards the net and missed it. Williams is after attack for Brown, going to the net, feeds it across, oh, by Stars, what a stop by Price with the backer. Price up with a save off Jake Muzzin. He's got his number early in this game. Here's Lewis. Back for Doughty. Drew Doughty spins and looks for help. Gets away from Gallagher. Doughty trying to center. Price blocked it loose in the crease. A scramble. He's down. And what a position he's in, like Gumby with his legs stretched backwards, but he keeps the puck out.
What strength by Carey Price to make sure that puck doesn't cross the goal line. But early on, you look at Jake Muzzin here. Gets the Carey Price clearing pass right off the noggin. But I think this wakes him up because next play on the power play, Muzzin gets it. Look at the patience. This one almost goes off the Montreal defenseman and into the net. And then Dustin Brown, who does he find? Muzzin again on the back door. But Carey Price comes sprawling across to make the spectacular stop on Jake Muzzin.
12 saves already for Price.
And that's a lot of Muzzin.
Here's Markov trying to go up on the wing. Lewis went to tip it away. Now it is brought out. Here's Andrew Gitto looking to feed it across to Markov, but it's intercepted by Braden McNabb. Sakak shot the line. Upended by Green. McNabb back on it. Trying to feed it across. King is there. He'll chip it in on Adam Price. Plays it across for Subban. Swung around the glass. Good hand-eye coordination at the line by McNabb to keep it in. Right King, looping the net, trying to escape Markov, hands it off to Green, throw towards the goal, block with the skate of Sven Andrighetto, and he'll get it up the boards and out as Plekanec was hit by Green, who was coming in from the blue line to make the play. Matt Green, on it again, he'll dump it in wide of the net, Gilbert after it, that'll be an icing call, charge to the Kings.
Take a look at Yuri Sakac there. I think got a stick on that shot by P.K. Subban. And he's fit in quite nicely with Thomas Plekanec. He's been juggled around early on in the season. Sakac was in and out of the lineup, but I think he's really came into his own with his recent play. He's such a strong player, and he's able to hold that puck and take it hard to the net.
McNabb. Let the pass across. Gabbert tipped it in, and Yemelin's there to fire it around the boards. Brandon Crust waiting for it. Had a little misstep. Now it's picked off. Here's Kopitar with it. Runs into a maze of red sweaters, so he cuts wide. Martinez fires from the line. Price kicks that one out, and Gilbert will clear it. Regier off the boards, broken up by Weiss. Price checked in front of the Kings bench. Kopitar to Brown, across for Gaverick, in with a shot. Yemelin got a stick in the way. Kopitar, tangled up with Brandon Crust. Now it's Brown for Martinez with a shot that's blocked by Weiss. Martinez hustling forward and he holds it in. Yemelin knocked down by Gaborik. Puck swung around the boards, and that'll skip all the way back down to the King zone. Jake Muzzin hands it back for Doughty. Now Carter up with it. There's Carter gaining the zone. That got deflected. Carter after it again. Trying to get away from Subban. Thrown to the point. Doughty with a shot. Blocked by Price. He'll poke it away. And Pacioretty knocks it forward. Gallagher is on it. Flips it up ahead of Muzzin. Catches up to it. Gallagher trying to hand it off for Pacioretty. Muzzin has his stick tied up though, and he'll send it to the corner where Doughty goes after it. And Galchenyuk's right there on him. At the line, Subban will keep it in. Doughty is back on it. Drew Doughty finding his way through center now in the Canadian zone. Doughty swings it in front. Nobody there in a white sweater. Pearson had a look where he wanted to put the puck before he had it on his stick and ends up missing it. It comes out. Pearson on it again. Beauty's the connection with a big check, knocking Pearson down. Andrew Ghetto will play it back in the King zone. Green going after it. Swung around. Sakosh trying to play it again, but it's broken up. And the Kings get it back as Williams is on it. Here's Green. Over to Williams. Andrew Ghetto trying to bring it in, but that ends up being an offside at the line. Yerji Sakosh throwing his weight around in this one on the Kings. Habs up 1-0 on Sportsnet. Montreal Canadiens hockey on Sportsnet is presented by Rogers.
Hey, take a look at Michel Therrien. He's got to be happy at the play of the Montreal Canadiens as of late, but when you're playing a counter-punch team and a physical team like the Kings, you got to make sure you get pucks in deep. And you watch Brandon Prest right there. He doesn't get the puck in deep, and all of a sudden, the Kings are on the transition game. They end up getting the puck in the Montreal Canadiens zone there and had about a 60-second sequence where they got a couple chances.
Green played it back to McNabb. He was met by Weiss. Kings get the puck to the line off the stick of Gonchar. Green dumps it in as Price. He'll block it back to the goal. Brings it around the glass, and now it is Malhotra that'll hand it off for Bonneval. Gonchar rolls it in. Bonneval trying to get to it. McNabb is there. That's a chip. Back down intercepted, so Green goes across for Williams. And he'll find a little room. Slows up. Hands it off for King. Backhanded towards the net. Price stopped and lost his stick in the process. Now Regier sends it in deep for Stoll. It'll come off the backboards, and Price puts his blocker hand on it to grab the puck.
There's no secret to the success of the Los Angeles Kings. They don't do anything fancy out there. They just come at you. The spirit's similar to the period last night in Ottawa where they're a little bit sleepy, getting some chances, but you always hear that term. They're a big, heavy team. You'll start noticing the Kings more and more as the game goes on because they just keep hitting you and hitting you and hitting you. And their game plan is to hopefully wear you down by the time the third period comes along.
They lead the NHL in hits with 896 coming into the game tonight. So no doubt they'll easily clear that 900 marker probably by the end of this period. Martinez throwing it towards the net. That got blocked. Sakach trying to knock it down. Clifford is there. He'll play it back to the corner, and Toffoli couldn't get a stick on it. Nathan Beaulieu tied up on the play by Richards. Now it's Sakach that'll get it out for Andrew Ghetto. Knocked it down out of the air, trying to catch up to it. Regier will bat it out, and that puck comes back to center. Nathan Beaulieu wrapped it in off the glass. Regier tied up on the play. Andrew Ghetto comes in to help out. Richards there as well. Trying to get away from Sven Andrighetti. Now does, as Toffoli. Meant to move it forward for Clifford. Beaulieu got his leg in the way, and the Kings and Canadians both scramble for a change here. Nathan Beaulieu will take it for a skate. Little dink pass, trying to get it up to the line for Palantol, but that ends up being an offside.
Canon's best-in-glass sale. Save big on cameras and lenses for a limited time only. Visit canon.ca/best-in-glass today.
Well, if history teaches us anything, this should be a good night for the Montreal Canadiens.
Panatol got clipped off the draw. Michel Therrien up on the bench is incensed here that there was no call, and now they get the whistle as Graham Reinband, the athletic therapist, jumps to boards to come out and attend to P.A. Panatol.
It looks like P.A. Parenteau got a stick right in the face off the faceoff. And
the officials are having a little discussion here right now.
I don't think they're going to call anything, though. They're pointing to a faceoff right now. And I think it might have been the stick of Marion Gaborik that came up and got Parenteau right off the faceoff. And I don't know how any of the four officials missed that one, because watching the replays up here, it was pretty evident. We'll take a look at it right here. It's almost like he rakes the mouth of Parenteau. An old school wrestling play there, right off the faceoff, but obviously none of the officials saw that. I don't blame Michelle Therrien for being incensed.
Muslin will dump it in, and Markov is on it. Andre Markov plays it into the feet of Subban. He'll air it out at center. Pacioretty trying to catch up to it. He does! Shoots! Just missed on the short side by Jones. Kopitar up ahead for Brown. He'll turn it back up ice. Dustin Brown rolls it back for Muzzin. Feeding it across to Kopitar. Kings can't get the shot through. Doughty will roll it back into the Canadian zone. And Markov is there. Quickly up for Pacioretty. Handle the hot pass, and Doughty bends it across in his own zone. Muzzin gets it up for Lewis. Lewis in on his own, throws it wide, and Plekanec is there to bat it off the board to know. Race forward here. Braden McNabb's got the jump on Sakac. Sakac trying to catch up to him as Green is up with a puck around for Lewis. Yamelin there to meet him and hold it in. Carter hands it across for Tanner Pearson. Back for Lewis. Lewis trying to streak in. Down low. He runs out of room and is taken into the end boards by Yamelin.
Yamelin lost body position. He was fortunate. But that puck was just too far.
Now Sakac striking in. Carter knocks him down. That's going to be a penalty to LA. Carter's going to get called for boarding with 4 seconds left in the period.
What a great shift by Jurgi Sakac. He was all over the ice, skating, winning races. Now he draws a penalty here with 4 seconds left in the period. Just some great energy on the penalty kill there by Sakac. Take a look right here. Sakac keeps his feet moving. And for Carter, he sees the numbers, but he keeps coming. It's not that it's the hardest of hits, but it's the position that Sakac is in when Carter makes contact. He sees the numbers, doesn't let up, ends up getting the call.
So the Canadians might have an opportunity here to set up one play off the draw if they win it. Desharnais will square off against Kopitar. And Kopitar won it. Doughty is there. He'll get it off the glass. Subban knocked it down, throws it towards the net. But that will be called on a high stick, and they'll bring the faceoff all the way back down to the Canadian zone, as it was a high stick on the power play.
0.5 seconds left in the period here, but nonetheless, they're going to line them up here one more time. But can't say enough about the first period that Jurgi Sakac has had so far. He's been playing with a ton of energy, killing penalties, and you can see the trust that Michelle Therrien is showing in him by putting the young player on the penalty kill.
Now Holtra against Brown, and they just scrub it off the drives, chopped to the net by the Kings after the siren, and nothing more will come of that. But LA outshoots Montreal 14-4 in the first period. Get going. They'll start with Pacioretty, Galchenyuk, and Gallagher up front. Markov and Subban to patrol the blue line. Kopitar and Brown out front for the Kings. They have Regier and Muzzin on the back end. As Subban will dump it in. Pacioretty after it. Tipped away. Galchenyuk deflects it to the corner. Pacioretty swung it back around. Subban is there. P.K. Subban handing it off for Gallagher. Try to pass across to Markov. That was blocked by Brownski. Now Brown intercepts Galchenyuk's pass. Dustin Brown curling with the puck. He'll send it in deep. Kopitar is there. Kings intent to burn off a little bit of time. And Brown will do that. Sending it back for Doughty. And Drew Doughty will take it for a bit of a skate. Now sends it all the way back down the ice. P.K. Subban settles it down, drops it off for Markov. He'll roll it up, and P.A. Parenteau is there waiting for it. Played across to Adam. They had to jump by the hit of McMahon. Stan Andrichetto on the puck, curling around with it. Andrichetto off for Desharnais. Throws it to the line. Gonchar from Markov. Scores! Power play goal. The Canadians are 2-for-2 on the man advantage.
Well, the Canadians power play that came in at 13.6% gets it second of the night, and it's off the stick of Andrei Markov. But it's all about the quick puck movement for the Canadians. It goes back to the point. Gonchar takes little time. He gets it right across and puts it on a silver platter for Andrei Markov, and he blasts that one-timer. Martin Jones.
I think Brendan McNabb may have got his stick a little bit on that shot, just enough to fool Martin Jones.
Yeah, usually don't beat a goaltender, even with a one-timer from that far out, so I think it was tipped as well.
So Andrei Markov with his fourth of the year and third power play goal. Now 1 point behind Pierre Mondeau for 26 all-time in the Canadiens points list. Puck comes in wide of the net, and that'll be an icing call against LA.
Hey, look at Andrei Markov. He does a nice job, and it's sometimes not how hard you shoot at the puck, it's how quickly you get it off your stick, and it goes from one side of the point to the other. And you're right, John, this goes right off the stick of Braden McNabb. This is the thing, if you're going to block a shot with your stick, you better make sure you stop it, because if you don't, it's going to be tipped, and right there it ends up in the Los Angeles Kings net.
McNabb from Davidson, Saskatchewan, no doubt has Graves' voice ringing in his head right now. Kids, get your stick out of the way. Let the goalie handle it.
I still think if you're a defenseman, you got to stick that stick out when the forwards go wide on you.
Great play by Galchenyuk over to Yemelin. Back in front. They scramble for it, and it rolls wide. Alex Galchenyuk showing off some nifty skills. Pacioretty for Gallagher. They'll bring it in again, throwing it on net, and Jones will kick it away. Pearson throws it up the boards. Pacioretty to the line for Yemelin. He'll throw it in wide, and the Canadians get the line change as Jake Muzzin works it up for Pearson. Dropping it off for Richards. Richards back in front for Pearson. Tipped it wide of the goal. Here's Martinez throwing it back in front. Gilbert blocked it. Desharnais on the attack. Trying to turn the corner on Martinez and crossed up at the line as Parenteau was still heading in. It ends up being an offside.
Take a look at Alex Galchenyuk, and so much has been said about Galchenyuk in the city about playing center, and this is going to be a good test for him tonight because he's playing probably against the deepest group of center icemen in the NHL, and he's got those nifty hands, he's got the skill set, but when you're playing against a big, strong Western Conference team like the Kings, this is going to be the true test for him, and tonight he's really stood up to the challenge so far.
One thing about Alex Galchenyuk, Brandon Gallagher talked about earlier in the year, he's so good when he's in the middle of the ice of going either way, left or right. And that really causes trouble for the defense because you have to respect that he can beat you either side.
Yeah, and when you play wing, and I have for a few weeks, you have blinders on. And he said when now he's in the middle of the game, he can see everything again now.
Here's Parenteau trying to get in front for Desharnais. Back for Nathan Beaulieu. With the shot, Jones kicked it out. Beaulieu holds him in at the line. Nathan Beaulieu trying to get a little room, and he'll send it in deep. Ends up back for Parenteau. Parenteau to Desharnais. David Desharnais hits the brakes away from Martinez. Back for Brandon Press, tied up by Richards. Now Martinez knocks it across for Williams, and the Kings get it out. Look here, Attico off his stick, and Gilbert will fire it back in. Alec Martinez up the boards, Bonneval broke it up. Dale Reese trying to kick it free, and does. To Manny Malhotra, and he ripped the shot wide. Subban stood up by Clifford. Reese trying to move it, rolled to the corner. Richards up the boards, he'll get it off the glass and down the ice. Markov back for it, icing rained out. Only over 21,000 linesmen in the stands didn't like that call, but Markov will curl back with it. Looked it ahead for Malhotra. Here's Reese with it, dropping it for Subban. Fires, scores! Oh! Subban unloads his shot that ends up going through traffic and through Martin Jones. It's 3-0 Montreal.
Well, it's all off a great transition here by the Canadiens. It begins with a nice pass in the middle by Markov. Malhotra kicks it out wide, and then Weiss just lays it out there for Subban to just walk right into that, almost like a seeing eye shot here. Here's the thing, when you hit the net, you just elevate it off the ice a couple inches, you give yourself a better chance of squeezing through the legs of Jones there. That's exactly what that shot does. Subban fires it, it's a seeing eye puck that finds its way through Jones's legs.
So Subban, who thought maybe he would have had the first of the game, once they eventually changed that, he gets it back for this one. Subban's back for the year. Now it is Brown bringing it back in for LA. Kopitar up with it. Kopitar trying to play it. Well, that got cleared away, and Plekanec is back on it. Thomas Plekanec looking to center for Sakonch, and that got broken up. As Manny Malhotra has picked up his first point with the Montreal Canadiens, getting the second assist on the Subban goal.
Yeah, I think I see Malhotra wiping the sweat off his brow in relief on the bench right now. Here's finally.
To Regier with a shot. Grubbed by Price through traffic.
Take another look at this goal by PK Subban. Markov with a nice little touch pass, and then Malhotra kicks it out. I like that little play by Weiss. It's an art to put the puck in a place where Subban can walk right into it, and that's exactly what Weiss does. And you look at Jones, who's had some great numbers as of late. Tonight hasn't been that sharp, and it's a tough position when you're the goaltender watching Carey Price make save after save after save. Price made 14 saves in the first period, and Jones knew sooner or later he was going to have to come up with a big one, and so far he hasn't been up to the task.
I stand corrected on Subban. That'll be his eighth of the year, of course, because he'll change that first goal eventually. It would have been nine if it was his second, but sitting at eight right now. And has been one of the best point-producing defensemen in the past couple of seasons, as it's an icing call here against Montreal.
Take a look at Jonathan Quick, who played in Ottawa last night in the 4-2 Kings win in Ottawa. And we weren't sure whether we'd see Jones or Quick tonight in Montreal. Obviously, in the back-to-back situations, they decided to go with Jones. But Jonathan Quick, two-time Stanley Cup winner, most recently last year. And he had the slow start, but he's really been starting to play some great hockey as of late, and he was exceptional last night in Ottawa. Stood on his head in the first period and allowed the Kings a chance to win that hockey game.
And now, Trevor Lewis in the box for LA, and the Canadiens are going to go back on the power play once again. This will be their third crack, 2-for-2 so far. Markov feeds it up ahead for Pacioretty. Across for Galchenyuk, broken up by Regier, and it's clear. Subban across to Markov. Brings it in off the glass. Regier going after the puck. Feeds it around, but Gallagher broke it up. Got it over to Markov, and that puck got by him and back down the ice.
Tough bounce there for Markov, but I like the quick movement again by the Canadiens. They're starting to look more confident on this power play.
Max Pacioretty in on the wing with it. Takes it down, and he'll send it back around to Markov. Markov back for Max Pacioretty. Hands it up for PK Subban. Subban feeding it to Galchenyuk. Alex Galchenyuk for Pacioretty. Back to Galchenyuk. Has a look. Feeds it off the side of the goal. Pacioretty's there. Swung it back around. Subban will step in for it. Try to play it down low, and Robin Regier will clear it. Now Pearson knocked it by Markov. Here comes Tanner Pearson with a shot. Right on as Price will squeeze the arm against the body and hang on to it.
That was a tough save for Carey Price, and it was right in that seven-hole area that doesn't look like that difficult of a shot, but when Pearson puts it in a place right between the arm and the shoulder, that Price had to be very careful. And Subban, usually you want to put that puck down the boards, and that catches his partner Markov flat foot. He doesn't have a chance to recover. Then Pearson with a quick shot, but Price just squeezes that arm and makes sure that that puck doesn't squeak through.
53 seconds remaining in the hooking penalty to Trevor Lewis, as Palantho is on it for Montreal, leaning it to Gonchar. Sergei Gonchar up for Dan Mayen's try, feeding it back to Pelletier, knocked off their stick by Braden McCann. And the Kings clear it as Troy King will send it the length of the ice. Weiss hands it off for Gonchar. Sergei Gonchar trying to get the long feed for Sven Andrighetto at the line, but McNabb broke it up. Gonchar back for Gilbert. Pelletier across to Dan Mayen, has to stop for it, now gives it back for Gilbert. Connects with Gonchar, walks in and ripped it over the goal. King trying to settle the bouncing puck down as Regier will shovel it back in the net. Doughty is there to fire it all the way down the ice. Price moves it up the boards. Lewis out of the box. The power play is over. Kopitar. Tangle up with Dan Hick. Gonchar after it. And a penalty coming up here as Gabrick was interfered with in the corner with Sakach, and he'll go to the box. So LA will get a crack on the power play when we return. Jiří Sakach for interference, but it's 3-0 Montreal on Sportsnet.
Well, we talked about tonight's game being a marquee matchup for two premier defensemen in the NHL, and Drew Doughty and P.K. Subban, but it's been all P.K. Subban early on. And there's that goal in the first period. We're still wondering if Sakach got a stick on it, but right now it's still Subban's goal. And then Dale Weiss feeds Subban, and again with the big shot, Subban blasts it through the legs of Martin Jones. And how about this stat right here? Most points by defensemen since 2012-2013. This is updated. P.K. Subban leading that pack with 112 points.
Subban on the puck down. He got knocked down on the penalty kill, but got it out. Brandon Prust after it, trying to flip it over to Manny Malhotra. And he's tangled up with Jake Muzzin and knocks Muzzin down. So a power play here for LA. It was Sakach in the box. It's fired right on Price. He'll go to clear it. That's off the stick of Gamera. And Prust will deflect it in deep. Drew Doughty being watched by Prust. Swung it around to Kopitar. Andrzej Kopitar. Try to dump it in. Batted away by Yemelin. Doughty back in. Try to cut towards the middle. He's got to chase it down. Yemelin is there. Feeds it back for Subban. Carter goes flying over Subban. And the puck's picked up by Thomas Plekanec. Racing down the wing. Plekanec to the middle. A shot. He's hit by McNabb, but Jones still comes up with a stop.
That's another big hit by McNabb. He's had two big ones, and last night in Ottawa, he put Chris Neal out of the game with a huge body check.
Gilbert feeds it over to Malhotra, trying to deflect it out, still kept it in. Gilbert gets in the way of that pass. Now Pacioretty trying to play. McNabb back in deep again. Pacioretty throws it up the middle. It comes to Martinez. He'll fire it wide. Jared Stoll back up with it. Over to Martinez. Martinez tees it up. That's out the outside of the net. Markov will get it around the glass. Pacioretty chopped it. Kept in by Stoll. Markov throws it in front. Price is there. He's going to swipe it away himself to clear. Saw the opening and fired it out himself. Pass got away from Brown. Gilbert back to get it, as that'll be a whistle against the Kings.
Now, sometimes your best penalty killer is your goaltender because he makes big saves for you. But watch what Price does here. He just clears the puck himself. He says, forget this. I'm going to get the puck out of here. And earlier on, it's a big body check by McNabb again. He comes across the middle of the ice, and Plekanec, the last minute, just gets his head up. Big hit again by McNabb. That's his second big one of the night so far.
15 seconds remaining in the LA power play. A 3-0 lead for the Canadiens. Second period goals from the blue line from Markov and Subban. Dustin Brown battles his way into Canadiens Hill. Can't get around Alexei Yellen. Yellen comes up with a puck and now takes his time to feed it out for Dale Weiss. Out of the box is Sakach. Here comes Weiss with it. Weiss checks up. Looks for an outlet pass. He'll send it in. Back to the net. Dayarme is there to bring it around the boards. Weiss going after it. He runs into Jake Muzzin. Dustin Brown back in for the Kings. Dropped it. Reese picked it off. And now it's tipped by Downey by Deion Mays on his own in the LA zone. Deion Mays dodged the check from Rivera. And it's kicked back to the goal frame with Cross tussling and trying to get a stick on it. Up to Conchar. Went to shoot the one-timer and his stick broke. Now he's got to hustle back as Pearson is on it. Pearson with a chance. And he shot it wide on the short side as that's off the glass and ends up all the way back down to the Kings end. Look here. Played it around for Toffoli. Dropped it back for Drew Doughty. Pearson tipped it out. Brandon Prest is up with it. Tried to hand it off for Gallagher. Went in behind him. And Jones decides to cover it up and take the break. As we've crossed the midway mark of the second. A 3-0 Montreal lead with Canadiens hockey on Sportsnet. Presented by Rogers. Well, the Canadiens will have the weekend off, but they're back in action on Tuesday night with Canadiens Hockey on Sportsnet presented by Rogers as the Carolina Hurricanes are here at the Bell Center, 7:30 Eastern on Sportsnet East. All NHL regional restrictions apply.
Well, it's a pretty disheartening feeling when you have a one-timer and you break your stick and you're the last guy back. That happens to Gonchar. But look what he does. He just keeps his feet moving on Tanner Pearson, just skates with him, and eventually runs him out of room and gives him a poor angle shot on Carey Price. Nice play by Sergei Gonchar.
Kings up with it off the draw. Muzzin around the cross. Gallagher tried to knock it down. His stick came up and took Markov in the chin. That goes undetected. Pacioretty threw it back to the line, and it comes out at center. Markov's got it back up for it. Galchenyuk hands it over to Markov. Back for Subban. Up to Galchenyuk. Alex Galchenyuk dropping for Gallagher. He's got to catch up to the pass. Comes back out in front, and Jones will find it and elects to hang on for another whistle.
Look at Martin Jones, who hasn't been the busiest of goaltenders tonight, but he's had a couple shots just squeak by him, in particular the Subban shot. That's a save you have to make, especially on a shot from that distance. And so far in this game, Carey Price has really come up big for the Montreal Canadiens. Unfortunately for Jones, who's had a great season as a backup so far, just hasn't been able to come up with the big saves tonight.
Gilbert will take it along the boards. Now goes back for Kukanitz. Empty and wide. Sakach is after it. Sakach trying to get it for Yamal and Ingles. He'll send it back to the corner. Sven Andrighetto tied up by Matt Green. Richard steps into Sakach. Yamal on the pitch. Trying to hold it deep. Andrighetto dug it out, but Tyler Toffoli is there. And Toffoli will take it for a skate and lift it into the Canadian zone. Gilbert trying to get away from Pearson. Toffoli back to the net. Poked it away. Gilbert knocks it back around the boards. Green is there. Handing it off to Toffoli. Trying to center. Price got a stick on it to block it. Now looks for it. And Green has got it. Puck comes loose. And it's Plekanec. That'll take it out for the Canadiens. Trying to go by McNabb and then gives him a little bump on the boards as the puck comes loose, but LA is right back on it. Matt Green up ahead for Williams. Being watched by Bolger. Knocked it away. McNabb back on it. Throws it over to the open side. Gonchar will hustle after it and lift it in deep. Brody McNabb trying to get it out. Kept in by Bolger. Bolger down low for Dan May. Take it down back in it up by Green. Panato trying to find it. Williams comes up with it. His pass goes off the stick of Brown, who was reaching back for it. Now it's to hustle across for it to chip at the center. Nathan Bolger will bring it right back in. Throwing it off the backboards. Hit the side of the net, and Green is there to get it. Works it ahead for Williams. Panato reaches across at the line, and close play there on the blue line, and it's called offside.
Canadians doing a good job of winning a lot of those 50-50 pucks on the ice right now, and that's what you need to do when you're playing against a hard-working team like the Kings. And look, Parenteau's going to go to the box here, and we originally thought this was offside, but you look at him on that play, he's got his hands up in the air saying that Stoll's the one holding him, but it's Parenteau that's going to the box here.
So LA ends up with their fourth power play of the night.
I think Parenteau's gone to the box for a hold. I think they got him on the hold there.
That's the second penalty he's taken this evening. Now Holtrup, Connor off the draw, comes right in front for Brown, and shot wide. Muzzin hands it off, Carter back up high, down he shoots, blocked by Price. Rebound, Kopitar, backhander stopped by Price. Downey tees it up, stopped by Price. He'll hold on. And Subban's there to push Brown away from the front of the net.
Great couple saves by Carey Price there. And this is a key penalty kill for the Montreal Canadiens right now. The next goal in this hockey game is huge. It's 3-0 right now for the Canadiens. And you don't want to make this game 3-1. And Price, once again, gets outside of the blue paint and just does a nice job of making himself look big. And so far tonight, Price has been outstanding. Right now with the Kings out shooting the Canadiens so far, 20-10 in the hockey game.
Jeff Carter trying to scrum it off the draw, and the Kings come up with it. Carter won 71% of his faceoffs last night in Ottawa. Here's Brown, it's all out, great stop by Price. Carey Price does it again. Muzzin from the line, that's blocked. Plekanec will clear it out, and that one is all the way to the LA zone.
Well, Price looks like he's getting into one of those zones where you don't think anything's going to get by him tonight. He is really seeing that puck tonight. It's the size of a beach ball to him.
Kopitar back in for LA, trying to get around Gilbert, avoids the chop. Markov will take him into the boards. Sakach can reach it. Doughty across from Muzzin. Muzzin hands it off to Brown. Brown trying to get it to the net. Off the skate of Gilbert. Brown will give it back for Kopitar. Feeds it to Doughty. Back for Kopitar again. Kopitar with a shot. Stopped by Price. Rebound for Brown. And Price has got it again.
The Kings are really starting to make a push right now on this power play. And Carey Price once again getting called upon. And right here in front of the net, it's Dustin Brown who's left all alone here. Look at this. The Canadiens just forget about Brown. Brown goes forehand to backhand, but Price sprawls across and makes the beautiful leg save on Dustin Brown. See Brown having a look in the replay, as most players do, thinking, how did I not score there? How did he make that save?
Dustin Brown and his 29th game-winning goal last night, surpassing Butch Goring, Mike Murphy, and Anze Kopitar for third all-time of the Kings. Game-winning goal list. He's tied with Rob Blake. Here's Richards, handing it off for Toffoli, right back in front. Oh, and another brilliant save by Carey Price. This time off of McCann.
That one was reminiscent of Dominic Hasek, like, just sprawling across, just somehow manages to get his body on it.
And Reese, nearly with a hog tie move, trying to get out of the zone. Pearson, handing it out for Martinez. Over to McNabb. McNabb back for Martinez. 10 seconds left in the power play. Tanner Pearson, across for McNabb. McNabb trying to get away from Reese. McNabb, handing it off. Toffoli back to the line. Martinez fires that one as wide. Pattenton is out of the box. The power play is over. Toffoli off the middle. Diving play by Malhotra. That puck will get out. Pattenton hands it off for Dale Reese. End of the shift. He's content to lift it in.
What a great play by Manny Malhotra. Making sure that puck gets out. Sprawling, diving, doing anything.
Here's Sikas. Spinning around, handing it off for Plekanec, back for Gilbert, over to Beaulieu. Beaulieu shot, tipped in front by Bordeval, and Martin Jones got the quick foot out on that one. Now it is batted along the boards. Plekanec trying to move it. Lewis is there. Checked by Bordeval. Lewis leads it across for Green, and he'll send it into the Canadian zone. Gilbert going after it. Kings managed 6 shots on that last power play. 11 of their 24 shots tonight have come on the man advantage. Doughty backs up with it. Played it up ahead for Clifford. Kyle Clifford feathers it into the Canadian zone, and Nathan Beaulieu is after it. Takes a hit from Clifford. Puck comes around for Doughty. Doughty handing it off for King. Dwight King spins from the check. Feeds it over to Muzzin. Jake Muzzin trying to get it to Doughty and does. Doughty in with a shot. That's off a stick and over the net. Sakic will get it out, and Doughty's got to back up to his own zone with it. Kings on a change. Here's Williams bringing it in. Williams trying to drive it in, and does, crashes into the goal as he's forced wide by Bolger. But the puck stays out as a net comes off. And all the Canadiens fans, of course, worry about Carey Price. And he is fine, because tonight, the Price is right at the Bell Center against the Kings. 3-0, Habs lead on Sportsnet.
Well, Carey Price seems to be in one of those zones tonight, and I mentioned that puck right now looks the size of a beach ball to him. And the Kings on the power play, Downey with the blast, and then Brown is left all alone. Somehow Price gets a pad, and probably the best save of all on Braden McNabb. Somehow Price manages to get across and make another big save.
Carey Price, solid here again tonight against the LA Kings, who right now have outshot Montreal 25-11 in the game. Here's Gilbert trying to get by Gonchar. Held him up. Galchenyuk chipped it off the boards. Gabbert knocked it down. Gabbert in front. Williams reaching for it. Back to the front and in, and it's picked off by Galchenyuk. Now it's Galchenyuk back the other way. Hands it off for Pacioretty. Flip back ahead for Galchenyuk, trying to reach it. Rolling puck, stole his air, and now it is Muzzin that is checked by Galchenyuk. And he comes up for the puck. Hands it off for Gonchar. Over to Brendan Gallagher. Gallagher off to Pacioretty. Back of the goal, Galchenyuk is counted again. Has a look around, feeds it up for Yumelin. Yumelin back down low. Doughty got in the way of that one. And the Kings regroup. Williams across for Muzzin. Jake Muzzin up ahead for Williams. Left it for Gabbert. He'll try to fire it towards the goal. Pacioretty got his stick in the way. Gonchar leaves it for Desarmé. Now Desarmé will move it forward. Pat O'Toole is on it. Looked across to the far side. Saw Pacioretty, but he was going for the change. So didn't want to throw it over there to him. Now it's turned over. Here's Price. Lost a handle on it. And Brown tipped it across for Kopitar. Kopitar being watched by Markov. Got by him. Kopitar trying to escape. Brandon Prust tied up in the corner. Prust looking to move it. Subban hands it off for Markov. And Andre Markov will flip it out, and that puck will skip to set. Jeff Carter back on it. Feeds it to Brown. Dustin Brown driving the net with a shot blocked by Price, and Brown gets dumped. Green goes back of the goal. Subban has to sidestep Brown. Carter trying to reach it. Comes to Green, firing off the stick and wide. Brown's got it again, throwing it towards the net, and that missed. Green hands it off for Kopitar. Back to Carter. Carter taking it around the goal. Sends it up to Green. Tried the shot, and that one ends up in the corner as Subban will work it up the boards. Taranto will clear it. Brown holds it at the line. He wanted to step off of the change. Now will. Carter after the puck. Jeff Carter on his own. Centered in front. Bouncing puck comes to the line. Desarmé has got it. And he'll just lift it back to the Kings' end. Doughty plays it up for Richards. Back across to Foley. Will dump it in, and Yemelin will go get it. Pearson tracking him down. Let's say Yemelin. Hands it up to Malhotra. Can't get it out. Penalty coming to Malhotra. Richard shoots. Stopped by Price. Toffoli on it. Jones to the bench for the extra attacker. Pearson shot kicked out by Price. It is grabbed by Bonneval. And a tripping call will put LA on the power play.
Canon's best in glass sale. Save big on cameras and lenses for a limited time only. Visit canon.ca/best in glass today.
Well, Manny Malhotra is going to get caught here. And it's all because the Montreal Canadiens getting pinned in their own zone. And finally, Malhotra has to reach out as he hooks Kyle Clifford down to the ice. But there was a series of about 3 minutes where the Kings just had the Canadiens pinned down in their own zone and Price being called to make save after save. And the Kings, the last 3 minutes, have really started to make a push to get that next goal.
Power play number 5 on the night for LA. Richards up there against Plekanec. And it comes back to Muzzin. Muzzin with a shot. That one goes over the net. Subban will bank it off the glass. The Canucks can't get to it. Richards does, and his snap shot missed. Drew Doughty back on it. Doughty handing it off. Pearson. Down in the corner for Richards, missed it, Yemlin's there, and a backhander's off the glass and down the ice.
That's a smart play by Yemlin, not rimming it around the boards because the Kings would have kept it in, uses the middle of the ice in the backhand and makes a smart clear.
Doughty up ahead for Pearson. Dumps it back in, got away from Price. Toffoli trying to play, Pearson back for Doughty. Now he hands it off. Richards with a shot blocked by Yemelin. He'll bank it off the boards and get it back down again. Jones out of that will set it up for Muzzin. 25 seconds to go in the period. Jake Muzzin will dump it in. There's Markov to clear it again back down the ice.
The Canadians can get out of this period 3-0. They've done themselves pretty well here because the Kings have really been making a hard push here, and a lot of pressure on Carey Price in the last 10 minutes here.
Pacioretty will force Doughty wide, come up with the puck, and the period comes to a close, and it was a big one for Montreal.
Big period for the Canadians as their power play struck once again, and Carey Price absolutely brilliant in the second period here for the Canadians.
14-7, the shots in the second in favor of LA, but Markov and Subban have the goals. It's the Canadians up front 3-0 after 40 from the Bell Center. Third period still to come in this one. He did get one of those goals, Andre Markov, the other power play goal, although the Kings have been out shooting the Canadians throughout this game, and you're right, 3-0 could still be a dangerous score in this one.
It really is, and the next goal here in this hockey game is huge.
Here's Brown tipping it into the Canadian zone. Markov going after it, but Carter's there to knock it up on the wing. Thrown on net. Price will steer it away. Back out in front. Chance right off. Price the save. Second stop off of Brown, and Carter can't reach it. Muzzin hands it off. Here's Kopitar with it. Kopitar around for Doughty. Drew Doughty with a shot. Price the save. Can't corral the rebound. Kopitar shoots. Stopped by Price again. Doughty's in front. And now it is cleared as Doughty's back on it in his own home.
Well, those are big saves by Carey Price. It was close to being a 3-1 hockey game here in the first minute. And that would have been awful for the Canadians starting the third period.
Kopitar trying to work it in front. That one comes back to the line. Martinez is there. Handing it off to Dustin Brown. Brown trying to play it. Malhotra can't swipe it out. Kopitar throwing it in front again. Bouncing puck and out. It's brought up by Manny Malhotra. Malhotra will slide it into the Canadian or into the King zone as Brandon Prust goes after it for the Canadians. Yemelin is there. Back around the boards. Pearson after it. Dale Mann will step in his way. Brandon Prust hands it off. Dale Mann cutting in tight center. Oh, what a stop there by Martin Jones getting the pat out on power toe.
Beautiful feed by Desharnais.
Desharnais fighting for the puck again. Hands it off for Prust. Got it back to Alexei Yemelin. Yemelin down low for Desharnais. Desharnais trying to get away from her gear. Adam Pinn there. Prust comes up with it. Brandon Prust hands it off. Parenteau throwing it back towards the net. Desharnais on it again. Canadians now trying to keep some pressure on in the LA zone. Desharnais backhander got away from Prust. Didn't see it go by him. And it's lifted out by Martinez. Price moves it up for Yemelin. Now it's Parenteau with it. Got it across. Galchenyuk will swing it back in. Matt Green is there. And Green will take his time with it. Trying to feed it for Gamrick. Broken up by Gallagher. Gilbert takes a hit in the boards. Williams played it out front. That went right through the feet of Gamrick. And it comes back to center as McNabb is on it. Hands it off for Green. One pass ahead. Out of the reach of Stoll. And the Kings get caught.
Now the Canadians came in a little flat-footed in this third period, and the Kings really with an early surge in this third period, and Carey Price had to be sharp there. And then again, Drew Doughty just throws it at the net. Price reaches for it. Kopitar comes in, and Price somehow gets a shoulder on that, and then right back come the Canadians. Watch Parenteau. Nice little backhand play there. But Martin Jones gets across and makes the save.
There's Plekanec. Getting it into the corner as McNabb will work it up the boards. Green is on it. Played it up ahead for Jarrett Stoll, and it's ducked in. Price worked it around. Stoll knocked it down. Nathan Beaulieu trying to get it, and it's Andrew Ghetto that comes up with it. Stone Andrew Ghetto. Tipped it in on the wing. Muzzin going after it. Andrew Ghetto there as well, but it's wrapped around and comes back out. Sunan is there to tee it up to fire it right back in. Kicked off the skate of Williams, and Jake Muzzin is there. Handing it off to Doughty. Pass all the way down through center, and Kings get caught for icing once again.
Protect your engine in temperatures as low as 40 below with Mobil 1 Advanced Fuel Economy. Mobil 1. Energy lives here.
Face off back in the Kings zone. Galchenyuk will line up against Trevor Lewis. Kings win the draw. Doughty for Muzzin. Handing it out for King. Hooked it up ahead. That's tipped in the air by Tyler Toffoli, and Suman is on it. Markoff will lift it right back in. Muzzin going after it. White King. Threw it up the middle. That was nearly picked out by Pacioretty. Doughty's got it. Here's Drew Doughty with it. Doughty tried the shot. That knocked down by Markoff. Couldn't get it away. Jake Muzzin throws it on. That goes! Jake Muzzin gets it towards the goal, and the Kings break the shutout. It's a 3-1 game.
Jake Muzzin has been one of the hottest LA Kings recently. 3 assists last night, and it's a seeing eye shot from the point, and the puck's going to end up on the stick of Muzzin. He just walks, changes the angle, creates a shooting lane for himself, and that puck gets tipped on the way in. Watch again here. It's just a quick little wrister. I think that goes off Markov's arm and by Carey Price, so no chance on that play for Price whatsoever.
So LA gets on the board, and now in a 3-1 game, things might get a little hectic here as the Kings try to drive back in this one. Here's Yedlin. Bouncing it up ahead, Kopitar hook it up, threw it towards the net, blocked by Dan May. Brandon Prust will get it across to Panato, and they'll blow that back down at the line and bring it out.
Take a look at this goal by Jake Muzzin. And just a floating wrist shot, and sometimes these are the most dangerous shots because they take longer to get to the net, and more things can happen. As this puck makes its way to the net, it gets by Galchenyuk, and I think that ends up, like I said earlier, bouncing off Markov's arm and by Carey Price.
A couple of weird bounces in this one tonight for the shots that have got to the net, even for the Canadians, some tips and deflections for the goaltenders to handle. Here's Jake Muzzin. Up ahead for Kopitar, deflected in the Canadian zone. Kopitar leaves it for Brown. Dustin Brown being watched by Plekanec. Al tries to cut to the middle, throws it in front off the skate of Kopitar, and it is brought up by Sven Andrighetto. Up ahead for Sakac, dropping it to Andrighetto, trying to go down low, and Andrighetto will hang on to it now to battle with Jake Muzzin. Kopitar in to help out. Carter trying to chop it out. Yemelin couldn't hold it. That puck is down the ice. And LA will get a change as Nathan Beaulieu is back on it. Beaulieu starting back out. Feeds it across to Gilbert. Gilbert tees it up. That one's off the arm of Jones. And it's over the glass in the netting and out of play. Tomorrow night on Hockey Night in Canada, 5 choices of nationally televised games. Start your Saturday with Hockey Central Saturday at 6:30. Then it's the Red Wings and Leafs on CBC, the Blackhawks and Islanders on Sportsnet, the Ducks and Jets on Citi, and Lightning and Capitals on FSL, followed by the Rangers at the Canucks on CBC at 10. Visit sportsnet.ca/schedule for details. Galchenyuk for Gilbert, thrown right back on net, and Martin Jones will handle that one and hold on.
Nice play by Tom Gilbert, wasting no time, just getting a puck to the net. And Canadians with only 13 shots on goal so far in tonight's game, they're going to have to do a better job of getting more pucks on Martin Jones because it's been all Los Angeles Kings in the second and third, especially the third period here.
Here's Toffoli hammering it down the ice as Pearson goes after it. Pearson trying it up by Gilbert. Richards there trying to play. Gilbert picks it off and he'll feed it around for Nathan Beaulieu. Pacioretty up ahead to Galchenyuk. Can't get by Pearson and he'll chop it back for Gilbert. Gilbert wants to throw it up the middle. Richards got a stick on that. That'll force Beaulieu to hammer it down the ice. And they'll call that one, although Galchenyuk thought he was going to be able to get to that puck first.
It's always tricky with that new hybrid icing rule, and the tie is supposed to go to the defenseman, but I'm not sure if Galchenyuk had a... It looked like, at least on the first glance, that Galchenyuk might have had a stick length on him, but very difficult for the linesman to make that call.
Huck comes back in front. Gallagher had a goal behind him. He's diving for it. Knocked it away, but Williams has got it. Handing it off for Muzzin. Muzzin fires. Tuckered away by Price. Williams trying to escape Gallagher. Galchenyuk over to help out. Muzzin again shoots. Price has got it. There's Gamberg trying to get his stick on that shot.
The puck seems to be following Jake Muzzin around the ice, and it just keeps coming to his stick, and he keeps getting shots to the net. And the Kings approaching 40 shots on net almost tonight. And the good thing right there, Price sees the shot, and the Canadians do a good job of boxing out and letting Price see the shot.
Well, the Canadians have a little discussion before the draw. Mandy Malhotra wanted to set up the play. And they did make the official scoring correction on that first Montreal goal. Zakach from Subban and Plekanec, the power play marker.
It was pretty plain to see that the puck did go off Zakach's stick.
Subban up ahead for Plekanec. He'll hand it off for Zakach. Now it's Plekanec throwing it towards the net. That one goes wide. And it is tipped out as Williams is on it. Williams flips it ahead. Gaborik will chase it down. Gaborik stops, throws it towards the net. Price will make the save. He's cleared it away. Muzzin trying to throw it back to the net. It's in the air and gloved by Price, grabbing it like a shortstop there. Didn't want to take any chances.
I don't think Carey Price expected that puck to even make its way to the front of the net.
The Kings are on the board. It's a 3-1 lead for Montreal. You're watching Canadiens Hockey on Sportsnet, presented by Rogers.
Well, we talked so much about Drew Doughty and PK Subban in tonight's game. Subban's been exceptional tonight, but for the Kings, it's been Muzzin. And Muzzin has been buzzing tonight for the Kings. It happened early on. He took a puck to the head, and I think that woke him up because after that, he was all over the place. The puck just seems to be following him. He's already got 5 shots on net, and we still have about 15 minutes left in this third period. And then the seeing eye shot from the net, which has given the Kings some momentum and some life here in the third period.
Yemelin wrapped it around the boards. Doughty stopped it, tried the shot, that got blocked. Down shot. Like to clear it out. Kopitar lifted his stick. And Manny Malhotra will get it out as Doughty goes back to get it. Doughty hands it off to Muzzin. Up for Brown, escaping Desarmé. As Subban will play it back up to Desarmé. He's got help with Zakach. Desarmé drops for Reese back and front. Zakach trying to reach it, but it was cleared away as Kopitar will go after it. Kopitar upended in front of the Kings bench. Canadiens dump it in. Doughty is on it. Tipped it across for Muzzin. That puck comes out all the way down the ice, and Subban's got to go back and get it. Tipped. Jones can't play it now. Price will tip Matt Green in the corner. Markov's there to bring it right back in, but that would cut the linesman. Derek Nansen. And he maintained the play as he had the arm up, kept the call going down on one knee. There's Lewis. Backhand around there. Back by Price. Lewis on it again. Chipped in front. Price with the pad down and the save. And then it's a pile onto the goal crease on top of Andre Markov.
Well, some real good awareness by Carey Price. Just finding the puck and knowing where the puck is. And that's what the Kings like to do. They just throw pucks at the net
and they crash and bang for rebounds again. There's not much of a play, but what do? They just throw it at the net and hopefully get a bounce. And Carey Price had to be ready, because that's what the Kings like to do, just throw the puck in there and hope for the best. And with the size advantage they have over the Montreal Canadiens, they try and get those mismatches down low.
Sneaking in early on the draw was Pearson and Galchenyuk. Mel Holter won it. Yemelin's there to ring it around, and Pacioretty will deflect it out. Regier back on it. Out to Foley. Hands it up, and it's tipped back in the Canadian zone along the top of the boards. Pearson in the corner is met by Gonchar. Richards tangled up with Yemelin. Gallagher trying to move it. Comes right in front. Toffoli with a chance, and he shot it high over the net. And was looking for a call right after the play.
Well, Toffoli complaining he was hooked on that play, but missed the net by a good couple feet.
Richards with a flag today. Galchenyuk tipped it across for Yemelin. Bouncing puck. Mikhail Bonneval is here to hand it off for Gallagher. His shot is in the leg of Muzzin. Gallagher trying to hold it. Toffoli there as well. Montevallo looking to move. Gallagher can't get it towards the net. That's taken away, and Jared Stoll is up. Stoll stood up by Subban as he tried to come in over the line. Gowdy back on it for LA. Hands it across for Muzzin. Jake Muzzin feeding it over to Williams. Williams trying to get by Montevallo, but he's held up. Markov. We'll tip it around. Muzzin blocks it. Play back towards it. That's tipped it over the goal. And then Dale Reese ran over Jake Muzzin along the boards. This will draw a bit of a crowd.
Dale Reese given to Jake Muzzin, with the Los Angeles Kings usually like to dish out to their opponents, leading the league in hits. But let's go back and take a look at this chance by Tyler Toffoli. He's going to find himself all alone in front of the net. And Gonchar, just a slight little tug on the stick, is just enough to upset the balance at Toffoli's stick. And look at the season Toffoli's been having so far for the Kings. Leads the team in points. And the interesting thing for Toffoli, he only averages just over 13 minutes of ice time per game. And that's pretty amazing when you think about him leading the Kings in points. Most players that lead their team in points usually average around 18 to 19 minutes a night. Not Toffoli, though. He's just over 13 minutes.
Malhotra and Jared Stoll. Right there again. And it's Malhotra that wins it again. As Gilbert got it off the glass. Liberty Sakash will carry it up to Montreal. Snapped it towards net. That missed on the glove side. Andrew Ghetto trying to pat it in, but it's knocked away. And Gilbert's got a hustle with it, as Gabrick was chasing him down. Jake Muzzin feeds it back into the LA zone as Drew Doughty is after it. Doughty checked by Sakash. Williams up for the puck. He'll slide it back over to Jake Muzzin. Now moved forward and dumped in. Brown going after it. Dustin Brown looping around. Looks for a little outlet pass. He'll hold on to it. Brown shoots. Stopped by Price. Rebound. Brown on it again. He won't shoot. Yemelin got his stick in the way. Knocked him down. And the puck comes out. Matt Green will lift it back into the corner. Gilbert is there. There's Gilbert throwing it up the middle. Price will tip it away. Parenteau on the attack. Dernay going into that. Parenteau to Dernay. Scores! David Dernay snaps a 12-game goal. Stroud is first since November 15th against the Flyers, and the Habs are out front 4-1.
Well, finally for David Desharnais, and it comes off a beautiful feed by P.A. Parenteau. Desharnais one times the pass by Parenteau, no chance for Jones, and an extra long celebration for Desharnais and the Canadiens, as he makes no mistake. And what a sigh of relief for David Desharnais. Stuck on two goals for the longest time. And that's a huge goal for the Canadiens tonight.
He had just one goal in his past 23 games. But Parenteau set him up. He'll put it home. And midway through the third, the Canadiens have their three-goal lead back. Here's Lewis. In over the line with a shot. Tipped up Price. And the big rebound comes ahead. Pacioretty with Galchenyuk. Pass across. Galchenyuk's got to catch up to it. Alex Galchenyuk over to Markov, across for Subban with a shot towards the net that goes wide. And it is Lewis that brings it back out. Lewis throws it on net. Price a stop, and he'll hold on. David Desharnais with his third of the year and a big celebration as the Habs are back out by three with Canadiens Hockey on Sportsnet. Montreal Canadiens Hockey on Sportsnet is presented by Rogers.
But it's Tom Gilbert that makes the play here. Gilbert's not going to get credited with an assist here on the David Desharnais goal. But watch the smart play he makes behind the net here. Takes his time, and then he's going to wait for Brandon Press to come flying across the blue line. He tips it across to Parenteau, and Parenteau and Desharnais are off to the races. But it's Gilbert that makes everything happen off that first pass.
Here's Toffoli with it. Trying to backhand it in front. Gonchar will stop that. He'll get it off the glass and down the ice. Dowdy is back, and the Canadiens will get called for icing.
It's amazing how that works sometimes, and so much emphasis is put on goals and assists, but that's why you hear this all the time in hockey. The defenseman makes a great first pass, and people wonder, what does that mean? What does a first pass mean? You want to know what it means? It means exactly what Tom Gilbert just did. No assist, but a great first pass.
Here's Dowdy up with it. Drew Dowdy fires, scores! Drew Dowdy, a rocket of a shot, and the Kings are back within two.
Well, the Los Angeles Kings, they're not dead and buried yet in this hockey game. And it's Drew Doughty that comes up big for the Los Angeles Kings here. The puck just squirts back to him. Doughty just opens up, fans out to the outside, and he's allowed to walk right down Main Street and blast this puck short side by Carey Price. You give anybody that much time to lean into a slap shot from that part of the ice, I don't care who's in nets, you're usually going to score. And that's a blast by Drew Doughty right there.
Third of the year for Doughty on the Kings, 43rd shot on net. They're out shooting Montreal 43-15. Desharnais sends it in down low to Brandon Press, trying to get away from Martinez. Williams trying to play it, blocked by Desharnais. Williams has got it back. And look for the Kings to press now. Regier across for Gabbert. A cop to his stick. Price will tip it across to Gilbert. Yemelin trying to move it up the board. Still got in the way. Yemelin's got it again. Up for Price. Still backhanded out. That one ends up in the Canadiens bench. And out of play.
A couple big shifts coming up here for the Canadiens. You want to try and seize momentum that the Los Angeles Kings have going right now. And for the Canadiens, this is a huge face-off right here. You want to get puck possession off this upcoming draw here and not allow the Los Angeles Kings to get more momentum. And who do the Canadiens send out? Their best face-off guy right here, Manny Malhotra.
And he won the draw away from Kopitar. Cleared around the boards. Galchenyuk tried to tip it out by Muzzin, and again it ends up on the Canadiens bench.
Well, we talk about faceoffs so much, and some people think, well, how important are faceoffs? Well, if they don't win that draw right there, the Kings get possession, it allows them to get their cycle game going. And Malhotra, he's been great on faceoffs all season long, and especially now. This is when they really need him.
Malhotra won it again. Subban off the glass. Muzzin knocked it down. Throws it towards the net, and Markov will get in the way. Malhotra went to clear it out. It caught the linesman, but he gets it out on the second effort. Up ahead to Pacioretty. Now Galchenyuk carrying it in. Stood up by Muzzin. Kopitar plays it across for Doughty. Back over to Jake Muzzin. Now Kopitar trying to chip it out by Gallagher, and does a race for it here. Markov hustling back, and he gets to it before Carter. Bounce passed off the board, so Clifford at center trying to come up with it. Can't hang on to it. And now it's Pacioretty trying to make a play in the King zone. Muzzin took it away. Clifford. Cross-ice pass for King. Back over to Clifford. Hopped over his stick. Now he's got it. Throws it towards the net, and that one is wide. Lewis hands it off to Clifford. Back for Lewis. Shot right on Price to save. Clifford trying to buzz now in the Canadian zone. Gonchar will check him, and the puck comes out. Green going after it, and he'll swat it away before Plekanec could reach it. Gonchar up ahead for Thomas Plekanec. Knocked it for Sakac, and it's over his stick as Lewis is back there. Matt Green playing it forward to Dwight King. Stopped by Plekanec, and it's dumped back in the King zone. Green is there. Matt Green hanging on to it. Feeds it over for Martinez, and that got broken up. Martinez on it once again. Checked by Sakac as Pearson lost it in his skates. Martinez forced to throw it back for Green. Green has to go back across to Martinez. Now it is Pearson that will flip it out. Markov off the count at center. Canadians get it back, and Suman will back up with it. BK Suman lifts it high in the air. That's off the hand of Muzzin. Malhotra to blow the ball, and he ripped the shot over the net. Toffoli can't roll it up the boards and out. Stan Andrighetto held it in. Now the shot goes off the skate of Malhotra as Jones will push it aside. Pearson trying to play it. Point it out. After the puck, chopped that by Richards. Now it's Muzzin up with it. Hands it across for Toffoli. Yemelin swipes at the line. He kept it in. Bornemau with it now. Bornemau. Andrighetto scores! Sven Andrighetto puts it home for his second of the year.
Well, Sven Andrighetto is starting to become a clutch player in just his third game for the Canadians. Now it's 3 points in three games. Look at him fan out, get his stick into a shooting position, and Bournevel, nice saucer pass right on the stick of Andrighetto, and he just one-times that by Martin Jones. This new-look third line for the Montreal Canadiens coming up big here in the third period. Desharnais with the goal, and now Andrighetto responds to get the momentum back for the Canadiens.
So Sven Andrighetto, who scored his first goal in Dallas, gets his first at the Bell Center. And it's a 5-2 Montreal lead. Here's Pacioretty throwing it on net. Jones will block that one, and he'll hold on. A three-goal lead for Montreal as Sven Andrighetto celebrates on home ice. You're watching Canadiens Hockey on Sportsnet, presented by Rogers.
Well, it's Alexi Yamalin makes a great pinch here. Just swipes at the puck once, gets it, and puts it down to Mikhail Bournevel. And look at the sweet saucer pass right onto the stick of Sven Andrighetto. And Andrighetto does a nice job of getting his stick open in a passing lane. And then as soon as he gets it on the tape, just hammers it by Martin Jones. Beautiful play by the Canadians, and I love the anticipation by Andrighetto to get open. And look at the strong start here. 3 points now in his first three games with the Canadians. He's been a pleasant surprise.
Yemelin hands it back for Gilbert. Trying to clear it up the wing, and now it's Parenteau that'll grab it. P.A. Parenteau in for Desharnais across the crust. That's off his stick. Puck batted around as it's Williams that's on it. Feeds it up on the wing. Gabrick bringing it in. Desharnais trying to tip it in the air. Williams knocks it down. Trying to Prust back up with it. Prust will lift it into the King zone. Regier going after it. Parenteau chasing him down. Gabrick hands it across. Markov will dump it in. Gabrick is there. Back for Regier. Carter trying to move it. And it is brought out as Subban will take it back. Canadians with just five shots on net here in the third period. Here's a Thompson puck. Stick catch to the net. Right out of room. Dozier scores! Sakac throwing it back to the net will bounce it in for his second of the night.
Wow, that's all I can say on this one. This might be a highlight of the year right here. Sakac with a couple beautiful moves, and it looks like he's going to run out of real estate right here. It's almost an impossible angle, but a quick spinorama to give himself about a foot and a half over the goal line, and then he just roofs it on Martin Jones. Beautiful goal by Jiří Sakac. What skill.
The Canadians now lead as Pacioretty will send it back in the King zone. Braden McNabb hands it off for Carter. Now it's Gallagher on it. Gallagher flipping it to the net. Pacioretty trying to get it to the goal, and Jones had the pad on that. Subban up with it again. Across to Markov. Markov will lift it in. Pacioretty knocked it down. Back for Galchenyuk. Galchenyuk looking to make a play, but it's Pacioretty going in a front off of Gallagher, and he knocked it wide. Pacioretty trying to move it. It's tipped around the boards. Brown is on it. Brown across. Markov intercepts, and it's Gallagher that'll throw it in, but right onto the stick of Doughty. Through Doughty. He'll wire a long one in. Price stops it, wants to keep the play moving, so he pulls it to the line and out. Bonneval grabbing it. Trying to cut in, and an offside called against the Canadiens.
Los Angeles Kings now with 46 shots on Carey Price tonight. And Price again has been his stellar self all night long for the Canadiens. You look at the Kings bench there, and they got to be scratching their head because Price has stymied them all night long.
Here's Muzzin knocking it up the boards. Got it back for Green. Green lost it. Malhotra trying to get it in front. Bonneval is there. Boldier held it in. Now it's Green with it. Handing it across for Clifford. Cleared out. And it is Muzzin. That's got it up for Andrew Ghetto, who broke it up. Andrew Ghetto will feed it across to Dernier. And they blow it down at the line. Perrotto, again, having a tough night. Thought that he was onside, but no such luck. Sportsnet Pick and Play, powered by Kia. It's never too late in the season to join. Just select key players from Saturday matchups, and you can win one of two 2015 Kia Fortes. Enter now at sportsnet.ca. They don't like the draw. They'll do it again.
The building just buzzing now as the Canadiens up 6-2 in this hockey game. And
here's Palantil. Handing it across. Gonchar over to Emily. Alexei Emily. We'll dump it in. Regeer after it. Tipped it. And it's poked away by Jones. Palantil's right back on it. Circling around. Holds it in at the line. Dumped it across for Dernier. Dernier hit by Regeer. Plus trying to pull it out. He will. Centered in front, just out of the reach of Gonchar. Sergei Gonchar across. One-timer by Prust is wide. Pearson is on it. He'll spring Richards. Richards gets no further than the Canadiens' blue line. Yemelin back up for Palantir. Ties up McNabb as Doughty is on the puck. Doughty hands it across. For McNabb, back for Doughty. These two teams will meet again the first week of March in L.A. at the Staples Center. And it'll be a while before they'll see each other again. Subban across to Markov. Back over for Plekanec, passing behind him. He'll throw it to center. McNabb has aired it up and back in. Price stops it, leaving it for Subban. Got it high in the air. That'll skip out by the stick of McNabb. Doughty racing after it. Dale Weiss trying to chase him down. Stoll on the rolling puck. Will chip it in. Subban is there, and he'll clear it right back out. 90 seconds left in this one. Here's Williams with it. Williams will lift in. Price again to stop it, and Price again will play it. Doesn't want to get the whistle here. Wants to run the clock. It is, he's seen enough action tonight with 44 saves. Canadiens 6 goals and 19 shots. Here's Brown trying to get it towards tonight, and it's wide. Jake Muzzin back up with it. Takes a shot. Price has got it, and he'll hold on with a minute to go.
Well, one of the biggest storylines heading into this game was the battle of P.K. Subban and Drew Doughty. I think round one goes to P.K. Subban. Early on, he gets that nice assist on the Yuri Sakhach goal, and then he blasts one by Jones for his second point of the night. Drew Doughty has played 29 minutes tonight for the Los Angeles Kings with a goal and assist. Both defensemen have been exceptional tonight. You look at Subban with the goal and assist, much the same for Doughty. Doughty's won the ice time battle, but Subban on the end of the winning team tonight with just over 23 minutes of ice time himself.
Bonneval dropped it back for Subban. A P.K. Subban will lift it into the Kings zone, gloved by Jones, and he'll hold on.
Jones has been busy tonight. Not quite as busy as Carey Price, who's faced 47 shots, but it's always tough when you're at one end watching the other goalie make save after save, because sooner or later, you know you're going to have to make a big save. And unfortunately for Jones, those big saves haven't come tonight.
Puck slid back in the Canadian zone, and Subban is on it. Subban will flip it ahead. Horn of out for Malhotra. Across for Weiss. Can't touch it on the delayed offside. He'll clear the zone, and now it rolls out. Weiss back on it. Dodged a check of Brown, and now dumps it in. Martinez on the puck. 10 seconds to go. Fans rise to their feet. The defending cup champs will fall in Montreal. Habs win it. 6-2 the fight. The shots in the third in favor of LA, 47-20 in the game, but Carey Price